Well, the rains have come and gone, and right now clearing off to the left. As comfortable conditions here tonight in Cleveland. 72 degrees to begin the ball game tonight. No breeze to speak of. The flag out in right center is pretty much still as Cliff Lee gets himself ready to go here against Julio Lugo to begin action. Again, about a 30-minute rain delay tonight. Lugo at 226 with 6 homers and 47 runs batted in. And Lugo takes strike one as we're underway.
Red Sox will see the fastball, curveball, slide it, and a very good changeup from Cliff Lee. Now, the last game that they played against the Texas Rangers, he and Martinez, the catcher, got into it. They were playing down in Texas, and on a 2-0 pitch, Lee hit Sammy Sosa in the head. Of course, that came on a night where there's a big celebration for Sammy. A lot of folks from the Dominican were there, and Martinez really took exception to that, and they went at it. I was told that they carried right into the clubhouse.
It sent foul down the right field line, back and out of play.
And there was some speculation that when Lee pitched, Martinez would not catch, but that's not the case. He's back in there tonight. But they had a pretty good go around and pretty much caused by that incident.
Well, for Lee, it has been a tough go of it lately, as you mentioned. 0-3 with a 10.69 ERA over his last 3 starts, but he starts tonight off by striking out Julio Lugo.
Fastball right down the middle of Julio Lugo. He doesn't like the call, but it certainly looks like a good pitch from Lee. Strikeout high is 9. He did that back on July 1st against the Tampa Bay Devil Rays.
So one down, and it brings up Dustin Pedroia. Starts tonight hitting at 318 with 4 homers and 30 runs batted in. And he takes strike one. Last 2 games, Pedroia's gone 0 for 7. And is 3 for 12 in the series against the Indians. He got hit in the ribs last night. And then he got buzzed up near his chin with another pitch. Both from Pastor Carmona. And then Cliff Lee quickly ahead, nothing in 2.
Now last night, Pedroia getting one right off the side early in the game, and then later on in the game from Carmona, he got one right under the chin, very close to his head.
Profile is brought to you by Sovereign Bank, the official bank of the Red Sox cable network. This season, the base is empty, 291 average. Runners on at 355 for Dustin Pedroia. Overall hits a 318 to begin the night. Field line as Gutierrez is on the move, but it's back into the seats, back and out of play.
Well, one of those very rare 4-game series, and of course the final game of the 4-game series for the Red Sox head to Tampa for the weekend. Well, for a while it looked like we may have to come back at another time to play this, but all of a sudden to clear it out, and it's a pretty nice night right now.
And both teams with a mutual off day on Monday. It appears we're going to be all right tonight. Red Sox shut out for the 5th time last night on Wednesday night, to the first time since June the 5th in Oakland that they have been shut out. Pedroia pops it up. Back comes Victor Martinez. He's got a play as he makes the catch leaning over the railing. Nice grab by Martinez, and there's two down.
Well, they have those dugout seats here in Cleveland. Of course, they have that screen in front of them, and Martinez actually turned the wrong way. Once he does pick it up, he has to go right to the screen to make the play.
So two down for David Ortiz. Red Sox DH at 320 with 16 homers and 60 runs batted in. Returned to the lineup last night after he had missed the previous four games with a left shoulder strain. On the ground, the shift on, it's Barfield. Back onto the dirt of the infield to throw out Ortiz and to end the inning. Red Sox down in order, the Indians coming up. Rhode Island fans, all kinds of people from Rhode Island here. The Pupper family. As Manny Ramirez leads it off for the Red Sox, sends one to deep center field. Grady Sizemore headed back, looking up, and that ball is gone. Straight away center field for Manny Ramirez, who hits his 16th home run of the year and puts the Red Sox on top 1-0.
Well, we mentioned that Manny took a lead deep in a game at Fenway Park earlier this season. It's the 16th home run that Lee has given up this year. And number 16 for Manny Ramirez. He jumps on that first fastball. And that ball going over, back over the hitter's backdrop.
Nothing Red Sox advantage. Kevin Youkilis down in the count, nothing in one. As he takes ball one, 1-1.
Manny's hit a few of those in this ballpark as a member of the Cleveland Indians and also the Boston Red Sox. That cleared that backdrop pretty good. That 400 to straightaway center field.
Youkilis on the ground this time to Peralta's backhand. And there is one away.
Kind of some interesting comments in the paper today by C.C. Sabathia. He's very disappointed in the fact that there's a lot of Red Sox fans here.
Saw that.
Get used to it, C.C. Red Sox Nation travels everywhere. But even Trott said, he said, I expect it because they can't get tickets at Fenway, so they travel a lot. I'm used to it. He said, but I'd like to see our fans, instead of booing when they start yelling, you know, let's go Red Sox, try something like, let's go Indians.
We've not heard that the entire series. All we've heard is the booing. Trott's right.
CC does not understand Red Sox Nation. He should become a member.
Will chops it foul, and it's 0-2. Well, 304 with 15 homers and 71 runs batted in. Four for his last 18 in the last five games. And last night off, as he shoots one by the dive of Ryan Darko at first base into right. And a one-out single for Mike Lowell.
Well, again, we mentioned many times, Mike Lowell does not strike out very much, 38 times, and he's not afraid to do this with two strikes. Take a ball that's away from him and shoot it the other way. By the dive of Ryan Darko, a very late dive by Darko, and the base hit for Mike Lowell. So a four-game hitting streak now for Lowell.
So one out, one on, and it brings up Jason Varitek. Varitek hitting at 265 with nine homers and 41 runs batted in. One hit in his last nine at bats and three for his last 23 coming into tonight's action.
That home run by Manny Ramirez traveling 481 feet.
Tell us that it is the third longest in Jacobs Field history. Jim Thome, 511 feet is the longest. Impressive nevertheless for Manny Ramirez. As the pitch in there for a strike at Varitek. It was quickly down, nothing in two. Red Voracek 1-for-7 in the series, but has walked 3 times. And 16th start for Cliff Lee of the season. Spent the first month of the season on the disabled list for the sprained right abdominal muscle. He was injured during a bullpen session in February and did not make the spring start, so that kind of put him behind the eight ball to begin the year. He was placed on the DL on April the 1st and then ended up making 3 rehab starts before coming back, and since coming back, 5-7 on the season. Roughed up over his last 3 outings, 0-3 with a 10.69 ERA. That works out to 16 innings pitched, 23 hits in those 16 innings, and 19 earned runs. Lifts it to deep center field. Grady Sizemore headed back. He will get there to make the catch out of the warning track for out number 2. And Lowell's back to the bag at first.
This Sunday afternoon, beat the Heat at Showcase Cinemas for another Nesson HD game night. Red Sox live. Catch the Red Sox in Tampa Bay. Devil Rays live at 1:40 in Nesson HD from the cool comfort of a Showcase Cinema theater. Visit Nesson.com for a season schedule and a list of participating theaters. Actually, that would be Red Sox game day. Nesson game day, right? 1:40 start.
And Sox in Tampa Bay. It's the second game day in a row, I think. Is crisp at 281 with 5 homers and 38 runs batted in. Red Sox first visit of the year to play the Tampa Bay Devil Rays, Tropicana Field. At the end of the bat, chopped softly right side. Barfield is there. And Crisp is gone, as are the Red Sox. But a leadoff home run for Manny Ramirez has Boston on top, 1-0. Red Sox batting in the top half of the 3rd inning with Boston on top, 1-0. And it's a number 9 man. Willie Mopeña leads it off here in the 3rd inning. Peña, Lugo, and Pedroia. As this one is grounded into center field for Willie Mo. Back up the middle. It's the 3rd Boston hit of the night.
It's been a real struggle for Willie Mopeña. Now he's 7 for his last 50. Takes that first fastball like Manny Ramirez, and this one on the ground right by Lee for the base hit up the middle.
So leadoff single for Peña, and it's back up to the top of the order for Julio Lugo. Lugo struck out looking his first time up. It's his second look tonight at Cliff Lee. Lugo pinch ran in last night's game and was caught trying to steal. And caught for the 3rd time this season. 25 stolen bases and 28 tries. Ball, and it's 1-1 now to Lugo. Side Barfield won't get there. It finds its way into right field. Peña stumbled around 2nd, but still will get to 3rd base. Hit the bag strangely, kind of stumbled just after reaching it. Well, he still gets to 3rd on the single to the right side for Lugo.
Has a changeup that Lugo hit that gives him now a 15-game hitting streak as he just kind of squeaks it through that infield. Gakko can't get to it, and certainly Barfield cannot get to it. Then the stumble around the bag by Willie Mopeña, but no problems. He's able to reach 3rd base. The Red Sox off quickly here in the 3rd.
Well, the 15-game hitting streak, a new career high. Well, Lugo did it in 2000 with the Houston Astros.
They're going to make an appeal, it looks like, at 2nd base. They're saying that he missed it.
No sign from Joe West yet.
Well, you have to put the ball in play. You have to go on the mound, go into your set position, then step off. He did not do that. Now he will check the runner, and now he can throw to 2nd base. And all for naught. Yeah, it looks like Willie hit right on top of it, but then stumbled, almost like he turned his ankle as he hit the bag.
So first and third, nobody out. And Dustin Pedroia, the batter. Pedroia fouled out to Victor Martinez in the first inning. Hitting at 326 against left-handed pitching. And one of his four home runs off lefties as he chops this one towards short. Peralta would touch second and fire to first for the double play. In from third comes Pena to score the second Boston run of the night. The Red Sox take a 2-0 advantage, but now two down in the inning.
Now the Red Sox hoping for more out of this inning, especially with a first and third situation, but do get the run on the double play turned by the Indians. William O'Pena coming across with a second run for Boston.
94th double play grounded into by the Red Sox. They are second in that category in the American League. So two down, bases empty, David Ortiz the batter. Grounded out to second base with the shift on, first time up. As he takes ball one from Cliff Lee. Some more fans from Rhode Island. I want to say Rhode Island is leading as far as all the fans we've seen here so far on the road from Red Sox Nation that have been here in this trip to Cleveland for whatever reason.
Well, because director Mike Narachi is from Rhode Island. So
is that why we're seeing all the Rhode Island signs?
Yeah, I mean, there's plenty of others out there from all over the country. I'm seeing a lot of Rhode Island signs on this trip to Cleveland. I've got to tell you, I've never seen this many Red Sox fans in Cleveland.
There we go. This is Wilmington, Mass. Making a comeback. There's a strike to Ortiz, who's taken all the way in the 3-0 pitch, and it's 3-1. How about Watertown, Mass? Happy 24th.
Hey, that's right.
Yeah, there's two big places in Watertown. Actually, three big places. Nesson, of course,
number one.
Lexus of Watertown and Eastern Clothing. All in West.
Let's go back to Woonsocket, Rhode Island.
Now I'm getting a headache. Enduring 180 for the trip, worth it.
Three two to Big Poppy. He has popped up down the left field line. Jason Michaels with a long run into foul ground, but it's back into the seats. As also joining him is Casey Blake, that long run over by the tarp.
Final staging arrangements have created additional seating for both sold out concerts by the Police this Saturday and Sunday, July 28th and 29th at Fenway Park. Tickets for these seats are now on sale at Ticketmaster.com. All Ticketmaster outlets and by phone at 617-228-6000.
Ortiz lines it to Byfield, who dives in short right to make the grab on the liner. It ends the inning. Red Sox get a run, take a 2-0 lead after 2.5. Portsmouth, New Hampshire. That's the first New Hampshire sign we've had. As this one has popped up off the bat of Jason Michaels over his low by the seats. Lowell leaps and can't make the catch. Did the best he could.
Well, I'm sure he appreciates you saying that, Doug.
Did a nice job, Mike. Way to get over there. Nice bid. Way to go, buddy.
Did the best he could.
Huh? Like, I'm right into position with him, too, because I got this big monitor in the way and I had to get up to get around it. So I'm up too, Mike. Jason Michaels, Franklin Gutierrez, and Josh Barfield featured in the inning against Gabbard has retired the first six. Michaels with 277, six homers, and 29 runs batted in. Michaels coming over from the Philadelphia Phillies in exchange for Arthur Rhodes prior to the 2006 season. Pops it up into shallow left. Lugo is back there. And there's one away. Boston Red Sox baseball on Nesson is brought to you by your Boston area Lexus dealers. Olympia Sports, the official sporting goods retailer of the New England Sports Network. And by Dunkin' Donuts. One down here in the last half of the third. It has turned into a pretty nice night here in Cleveland. After a 34-minute rain delay to begin the evening. And some pretty hard rains coming through, but the ground's crew did a great job in getting the field ready tonight and did it pretty quickly.
Yes, they did. I was surprised. I mean, once they decided to take that top off, we got going in about, what, 15, 20
yeah,
minutes?
Maybe even less, but yeah. 12, somewhere in there.
Excellent.
They got it ready in a hurry. There's ball two, and it's 2-0. And Curt Schilling tonight, pitching in Toledo. Ended up going five innings tonight, giving up two hits, no runs. He did not walk anybody and struck out eight. So he threw around 65 pitches. Well, he threw 66 pitches, 44 for strikes, and they get the first 14 batters. So Kirk was feeling pretty good tonight. Yes, five innings, two hits, no runs, no walks, eight strikeouts. And you can bet he thinks he's probably ready to go right now after this performance.
Well, 66 pitches, I imagine one more time out on a rehab, which would probably get him to somewhere between 80 and 90. And then I think after that, he'd be ready to get back on the mound for the Boston Red Sox.
Three-one to Gutierrez. On the ground, outside of third base, very close, but foul. It's time now for the Coors Cold Blast, and the only run scored in last night's contest, Franklin Gutierrez, his sixth home run of the year, as he takes Josh Beckett deep. Gutierrez, 24 years old. Swings at the 3-2 and hits it out towards deep left center field. Back goes Coco Crisp. And that is gone. So Gutierrez homers in back-to-back nights. And the Indians cut the Red Sox lead in half with a solo shot. He is seventh of the season. And it's now 2-1 Boston.
Well, Gutierrez has been the offense for the Cleveland Indians over the last couple of nights. Fastball that is down and in, and Gutierrez takes it to those bleachers in left field for the home run. Not a bad pitch by Gabbard. It was down in the zone.
Josh Byfield the batter. From Venezuela. And over from the Padres for Kevin Kuzmanoff. And it's a 252, two homers and 44 runs batted in. And 13 home runs last year with the Padres. As he pops it up, Pedroia drifting back to shallow right. And there's two down in the inning.
At 5:30, the Globe 10.0 presented by Verizon tackled today's top 10 hottest topics, but they saved an extra point for us. If the Falcons let Michael Vick go, would another NFL team sign him? Stay tuned for Sports Desk tonight after Sox coverage to hear Bob Ryan and Chris Gasper take on the extra point.
So two down, bases empty, and it's back up to the top of the order for Grady Sizemore, trying to bunt his way on it. Fouled out first time up. Take strike one this time. This is inside, ball and a strike now to Sizemore. Sizemore is only 24 years old. He'll turn 25 August the 2nd. And he was part of the deal that saw Bartolo Colon go to the Montreal Expos. Came back with his starting pitcher, too. Cliff Lee was part of that deal. Tonight's starter for Cleveland. Back on June 27th of 2002. Brandon Phillips also coming over as part of the deal. Lee Stevens in exchange for Bartolo Colon, Tim Drew, and Cash. Back in 0-2. Ball two, and it's now 2-2 to Sizemore. Originally a third-round pick by the Montreal Expos back in 2000. And this is now the fourth season that he has been with the Indians. Swing and a miss. Gabbard picks up his first strikeout. Gutierrez, for the first time in his career, has homered in back-to-back games. It's a 2-1 Red Sox lead. Top half of the fourth inning as Manny Ramirez leads it off and takes the first pitch strike from Cliff Lee as the Red Sox have a 2-1 lead. Manny got the scoring started tonight. His 16th home run of the year to lead off the second inning. Here he leads off the fourth inning. And he takes a ball outside, 1-1. The league leaders are brought to you by Olympia Sports. And it's home runs at Jacobs Field. Jim Tomey's got more, 178 of them. And now 130, including the home run in the second inning for Manny. Home run number 16 of the season for Manny Ramirez. Thought he had one earlier here in the series, one that was just shy of getting out of here in left field off the wall. Ended up only getting a single out of it. Side ball four. Manny walks, first walk of the night given up by Cliff Lee.
Join Theo Epstein, Kay Hanley, Peter Gammons, and a host of hot musical acts, including John Legend, on Friday, August 24th. The third annual Hot Stove Cool Music, the Fenway Sessions, benefits a foundation to be named later, part of the Red Sox Foundation. For tickets, visit RedSox.com or call 877-RedSox9.
A leadoff walk for Manny Ramirez to get things started here in the fourth inning. Third time in four innings. The Red Sox have had the lead runner on. As Kevin Youkilis backs, he bounced to shortstop first time up. So it bounces in and evens the count at 1-1.
You know, for the first time we saw Victor Martinez catching for the Cleveland Indians, he's made a great improvement, I think, behind the plate, throwing much better than he did early in his career, better at blocking balls. And of course, we all know about his offensive abilities.
He leads the Indians in average, home runs, RBIs. You're right. We watched him one day when he was really struggling here. It was maybe 2 years ago. And he was every day they practiced throws to second base with him. A couple of the coaches out there, Joel Skinner, and others out there working with him on a daily basis. And he just couldn't straighten it out. He was going all over the place. And it looked there for a while like they may move him from the catcher spot. But he has vastly improved over the last few years.
Yeah, a lot of that is footwork for a catcher. You know, getting your feet in the proper position quickly to make an accurate throw to second base.
Catcher Joel Skinner on the staff for Eric Wedge. That is back-to-back walks as Youkilis will make his way down to first base, and the first two have reached.
A Well, get a chance, Don. Happy 79th birthday to Ray Long of Putney, Vermont. Ray is a big Red Sox and Indians fan. That's from his nephew here in Cleveland, Kevin Long. Actually, Kevin's from Avon Lakes, Ohio, but happy 79th to Ray, who's watching the ball game tonight from Putney, Vermont.
First and second, nobody out. Back-to-back walks allowed by Cliff Lee. Here's Mike Wold, single to right field, first time up. Strike one to Lowell. He has one of four Boston hits tonight. Into right field, a base hit for Lowell. Ramirez will be stopped at third base, and the throw is cut off. As DeMarlo Hill stops him, Red Sox have him loaded with nobody out here in the top half of the fourth inning.
Second time tonight, Lowell's going to the opposite field. Looks like a cut fastball inside that he takes the other way. And, of course, with nobody out, DeMarlo Hill is not going to take any chances. A chance for a very big inning. Certainly don't want to have that first out at home plate. And he puts the brakes on Manny. And the good thing is Manny saw him. You've seen Manny run through a couple of stop signs every now and then, and even run over DeMarlo Hill.
This is loaded, nobody out. Jason Varitek, the batter. He takes strike one into the inside corner. This time up, he flew out to center field to the warning track. Grady Sizemore was back there to make the catch in the second inning. Grounded foul, and Varitek finds himself down, nothing in two.
Well, for a big part of the season, Veritek's average was much, much higher from the right side. Not the case anymore. 265 coming into the game right-handed, 266 left-handed. But for a long time, he was way over 300 hitting from the right side.
On the ground and through in the left field, a base hit. Ramirez scores from third. Yuko's going to try and score. The throw from Michaels is up the line. He's in. It gets by the pitcher, who is backing it up, but no further advance for the base runners. Two runs in for the Red Sox to take a 4-1 advantage.
Now the walks really hurt to lead this inning. Back-to-back walks to start the inning. The opposite field hit by Lowell. And now Varitek on that ground ball between third and short. Casey Blake looked like he slipped as he went into the dive. And this throw is going to go by everybody. The lead, the pitcher, is backing up the play. And eventually he's able to track it down. Manny somehow involved there. Where was Manny? Standing right behind home plate?
Yeah, looked like he might have been right there. And Carl Willis, the pitching coach, out to talk to Cliff Lee. That's now 15 RBIs this season and 14 at bats with the bases loaded for Jason Varitek, who knocks in a pair with a double here in the fourth inning. And the Red Sox on top 4-1. Coco Crisp will be the next batter. Two walks and two hits, and the Red Sox grabbed two runs so far here in the fourth.
And the infield has to come in for the Indians, already down 4-1.
On the ground to third base, base runners will have to stay where they're at as Casey Blake throws that Coco Crisp for the first out of the inning.
Coco Crisp has seen a lot of off-speed pitches in this series from his former ball club, the Indians. A lot of changeups. Change up here on the first pitch, and the result, the ground ball to third base.
So one down in the inning, second and third, and Willie Mopeña, the batter, singled his first time up. loops it out towards right center field on the run now as Gutierrez. He will get there. And bluffing and not going is Mike Wall trying to draw the throw. He does. So he remains at third, and there's now two down in the innings. Pena flies out to the right fielder Gutierrez.
Yeah, not deep enough to even take the chance of sending Mike Lowell from third base. Pena again swinging at that first pitch, just kind of a bloop out toward the right field, and of course Gutierrez had all momentum coming into it home.
So two down now, and here's Julio Lugo. He's one for two tonight. Lugo struck out looking in the first inning, single to right field in the third inning. Pops it up foul, back into the seats, off to the right as Garco gives chase. End of the hitting streak to 15 straight games with his base hit in the third inning. Pitch outside of the count, one and one down to Lugo. He walked the first two batters that he faced to begin this inning. They have both scored. A single for Lowell, single for Veritek. Settled down to get Crispin Pena. Now the dive at second base by Barfield. A throw, and Garco digs it out. Rui Alcaia thought he was safe even so, but the Red Sox come away with two runs and lead it 4-1. Top half of the fifth inning, Dustin Pedroia, David Ortiz, and Manny Ramirez to face Cliff Lee. As the first one misses to Pedroia, is 0 for 2 tonight. Fouled out to the catcher, Victor Martinez, in the first inning, and then bounced into a double play in the third inning. He had the tough start last inning in which he walked back-to-back batters. Both those batters scored. As the first four reached against him in the fourth inning. Two walks, two hits. Here's a hit for Dustin Pedroia. Lines it into left field for a leadoff single.
Looks like the slider from Lee down and in, and Pedroia picks up the base hit. So Pedroia, who had been 0 for his last 9, now with the base hit, also the fine defensive play in this game. Of course, the double play hit in 2 in the third inning brought home a run for the Red Sox.
Well, lead runner on for the fourth time in 5 innings tonight for Boston. As David Ortiz stands in 0 for 2. David is grounded out to second base and lined out to second base in 2 at bats. As he takes strike 1 from Cliff Lee. But it's a ball, 1-1 now to Big Poppy. Another first strike has Ortiz looking back at Ed Hickox, and it's 1-2.
Looks like a pretty good pitch. Certainly high enough, and it looked like it had the corner.
Well, Red Sox getting their first home run of the series tonight. Manny Ramirez in the second inning. Red Sox have not homered in the first 3 games of the series. We're waiting on deck with nobody up. Dustin Pedroia at first base. Full count now to Ortiz. White Sox are 4-2 against the Indians this season. Able to take the first game of the season series against Cliff Lee. And as Ortiz walks, there's the third walk given up by Lee. First two have reached.
As a great new look for the Red Sox Nation program in 2007. New rewards, gifts, and unique ticket opportunities. Sign up right now to become a member of Red Sox Nation. A lot of good things coming up. I told you last night, Don, that we have this cabinet meeting coming up tomorrow morning to discuss how we can improve things for Red Sox Nation members. And I asked people to last night send suggestions to john@theremreport.com, and we got a lot of them, and still reading through them, and some good ideas that we'll bring to the table tomorrow morning. So if you got suggestions, send it into the Rem Report tonight, john@theremreport.com.
Who's at first and second, nobody out. And Manny lines it down the left field line. This is a fair ball as it heads towards the corner. Over to play it is Michael. Scoring from second is Pedroia. A double for Ramirez as Ortiz stops at third. The Red Sox take a 5-1 lead.
That's the second time Manny's jumped on the first pitch. For the first time, it was a fastball for a home run. This time, it's a changeup for the double. So Manny with two runs batted in tonight. Now at 62, he's creeping closer and closer to the top 10 in the American League.
And Manny swinging at 29% of first pitches. He's done it twice tonight with some pretty good success. As Carl Willis, the pitching coach, back out to talk to Cliff Lee.
Also, when you go to make your suggestions for the Rim Report, check out and see if you won tickets, the free tickets for the brief homestand against the Baltimore Orioles. Only three games, so the names are all listed on there for the winners.
I wonder if we will have a new list of possible presidents for Red Sox Nation when we get home. I know they updated it last time we were home, and I imagine there's many more since then that have jumped into the race.
Yeah, I've got some names, but I can't divulge them publicly, you know, because it's classified information. But I'm sure they'll be making that public very quickly. It's going to be, I imagine, quite a race.
So second and third, nobody out. Run in for the Red Sox, who lead it 5-1. Nicholas has grounded to short and walked so far as he takes ball one.
One of the things I found since I've been in this interim president is a lot of stuff I can't talk about because it becomes top secret.
Well, you can't just throw everything out there. I mean, there's got to be some stuff. There's got to be a file for that stuff.
It's got to be all filtered, you know. I haven't even had time to think if I'm going to run. I really haven't. It's almost like a 24-hour day job. Conference calls, teleconference calls, you know, all kinds of stuff.
Meet and greets, you know, people show up, you got to shake hands, photos, a lot of photos.
Kissing babies.
I noticed you write your own speeches, though. You don't have a speechwriter. You do that yourself.
I do. If I'm going to make a fool out of myself, it's going to be myself that does it.
Well, on the ground, the infield in. It's knocked down by Peralta, and he can do nothing with it. At least he stopped the run from scoring, able to knock it down, but reaching it first is Euclid, and they charge him with an error.
Yeah, I think that's a correct call because it was a ball that he could have handled. They're not going to try to score Ortiz on that, but he could have had an out at first base. Doesn't have to go that far to his left. It just kicks off the heel of his glove, and that'll load the bases for the Red Sox.
It's the 15th error committed by Peralta at shortstop this season. And a base is loaded. Nobody out situation for Mike Lowell. As he takes strike one.
Well, the Red Sox got a great opportunity to put this one away early tonight.
Mike Lowell 2-for-2 as he has singled twice tonight, both times to right field. Calls it off, finds himself down, nothing in two. Mark Wedge with Stanford up in his pen. And Cliff Lee, who's really been roughed up lately, so far tonight has given up 5 runs. No 2 inside, and it's 1-2. We look back over his last few outings against Texas. Last time out, he gave up 7 runs. The outing before that, 7 runs to the White Sox. 6 runs the outing before that at Toronto. His last good outing, you got to go back to July 1st against Tampa Bay when he struck out 9, gave up just 1 run. This is in the dirt. And it's 2-2 now to Lowell. Comes into tonight's action with a record of 5-7, but an earned run average, it's almost up to 6. Comes in at 5.95. Career numbers against the Red Sox, 2-2 with a 3.72 ERA. He lost against Curt Schilling. As Lowell sends it into right center field for a base hit. Ortiz scores, Manny Ramirez in behind him, and the Red Sox lead it 7-1.
A big night for Mike Lowell, his 3rd hit. Infield in, this ball up over the head of Barfield. 2 more runs, and that's going to be it for Lee. That's his 4th straight bat outing in a row.
So Cliff Lee hands off the baseball, and he departs having given up 7 runs so far, still responsible for the 2 men on. This call to the bullpen is brought to you by New England Ford dealers. Have you driven a Ford lately? Jason Stanford will be on when we come back to Jacobs Field in Cleveland at 7-1 Red Sox. Cliff Lee is gone after 4-plus innings so far, giving up 9 hits and charged with 7 runs. He is responsible for the 2 men on. He was booed as he went off. And ended up tipping his cap to the booze.
Yeah, you know what this means? He's going to show them. But what it really means is they've got to him. And that's what that means. He's acknowledging the booze.
Jason Stanford's on now for the Indians.
8th appearance. He's made a couple of starts. His record is 1-1. We've seen him before in this series. He pitched an inning against the Red Sox, spending the majority of the year down at AAA Buffalo.
2 on with nobody out, and Jason Varitek carves it foul. Varitek is flying to the warning track in center field. He is single to drive in a pair of runs. Nicholas at second base, Lowell at first base. There's still nobody out in the inning. This one chopped towards shortstop. Peralta will go to second for 1, on to first. A double play. The second double play turned by the Indians tonight. As we send it back to Boston and Tom Karen. TC.
Another Toyota game break here as David DeJesus rips a double into the gap. Tony Pena, Esteban Hermann both score. Kansas City leading for the first time in the series. A 4-0 lead. Kagawa struggling as the Royals try to snap that 6-game Yankee winning streak. Guys.
All right, Tom, thank you very much. Red Sox with a 7-1 advantage here in Cleveland. The runner at third base and a first pitch strike into Coco Crisp.
Boy, Kagawa has really turned out to be a bust for the Yankees, yep. Hasn't he?
Sure has. They are close to getting Phillip Hughes back, which would be huge for them. And imagine maybe the end of Kagawa in that rotation. Well, the Red Sox made a move today as they signed Brady Clark, an outfielder, to a contract with the Pawtucket Red Sox. Brady Clark is 34 years old. He had been released by the Dodgers on June 18th. After batting 224 in 47 games, right-handed batter. He had a major league average of 277 with 36 home runs. He has been in the big leagues with the Reds, breaking into the big leagues in 01. Was with the Reds in 01 and 02. The Mets in 02. The Brewers 2003 through 2006. And the Dodgers this season. Back in 05, he had hit a 306 in 145 games with the Brewers. And he was signed as Jacoby Ellsbury was placed on the DL with a mild groin strain. So Brady Clark now in the organization and with the Pawtucket Red Sox. 2-2 the count to Coco Crisp with Kevin Euclid at third base, and Boston now on top 7-1. Fly ball sent foul down the right field line, back and out of play. Bull having a big night tonight with three hits in the game and a couple of RBIs. On the ground left side and in the left field, a base hit. From third base comes Euclid, and the Red Sox lead it 8-1.
Well, another off-speed pitch to Coco Crisp, but this time out in his front leg, but he finds a hole between third and short. So the two-out base hit by Crisp picks up his 39th RBI. Just kind of flicked at that ball. All that weight out on the front foot, his left foot flicks at it, but finds the hole. So the Red Sox offense alive here tonight.
Here's Willie Mo's got a hit tonight. He's 1-for-2. He's single to center back in the third inning. And he fouls this off to our left. The eighth batter for the Red Sox here in the top half of the fifth inning. Boston now has scored in every inning but the first inning. One in the second, one in the third, two in the fourth, and so far four here in the top of the fifth. And Chase Cliff Lee from the game, who was charged with 8 runs tonight on 9 hits. Walked 3 and struck out 1 on the hook, came in at 5-7 into tonight's action. And the fourth straight pretty rough outing for Cliff Lee. Pena drives it out towards right center field. This one is back and it'll one hop the wall. Coco Crisp trying to score all the way from first base. He will with the Red Sox 9th run. Boston on top 9-1. On the second hit of the night for Willie Mo, Pena drives in a run.
Pena with limited playing time and really struggling when he did get a chance to play. 2 hits already in this game tonight and the RBI. So with 2 outs, Coco Crisp with an RBI single, Willie Mo Pena an RBI double.
First RBI for Pena since June 29th. And his first multi-hit game since June 20th. A couple of hits against the Atlanta Braves. Coco scoring all the way from first base. And here's Julio Lugo. Julio 1-for-3 tonight. He's singled in the third inning. He'll be returning to Tampa Bay for the first time. Since leaving the Devil Rays for the Dodgers last year, be the first visit of the year for the Red Sox to Tropicana Field beginning tomorrow night. It'll be Tim Wakefield against Jason Hamill in game 1. John Lester against James Shields in game 2. And then Daisuke pitches on Sunday against Scott Kazmir.
For a non-winning 5- and $10 Red Sox Insta tickets from the Mass Lottery into cash with every Red Sox victory in the $1 million double play. Learn how to play at masslottery.com and stay tuned to Nesson after every Red Sox victory to see if you're a winner.
Lugo, the ninth batter of the top of the fifth inning here for Boston. With Willie Mo Pena at second base and 2 down here in the top of the fifth inning. Lugo, left field, sending Jason Michaels back. He's there, and he makes the catch that ends the inning. Red Sox send 9 men to the plate. They score 5 times, take a 9-1 lead halfway through this one.
Each time the Red Sox win at Fenway Park, Hood donates $1,500 to children's hospitals throughout New England. It's another reason to root for the Red Sox and another reason to feel good about Hood.
23-minute wait for Kason Gabbard while his team racked up five additional runs. Red Sox lead it 9-1 as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Ryan Garko, Johnny Peralta, and Jason Michaels featured for the Indians. Garko lines a foul ball down the left field line. Flied out to right fielder Willie Mopeña. First time up back in the second inning.
In this series, Don, you got to think the Indians might be in the market for a pitcher, whether it be a starting pitcher or somebody out of the bullpen. You know, once you get past Carmona, who was great last night, and CC Sabathia, nobody else really having a great season. Paul Byrd is 8-4, but a very high ERA. Of course, Cliff Lee having his troubles recently. And we saw Westbrook, who had a bad early part of the ball game and then settled down, but he is 1-6.
The problem will be, as most teams will run into, that everybody's kind of looking for pitching. And certainly tough to come by. As this one is lifted down the right field line over his Pena towards the line. And he makes the catch for the out.
Stay tuned after our Red Sox coverage of Sports Desk with Hazel May, presented by FW Webb, who invites you to be a Sports Desk anchor for a day. Visit Nesson.com for more details. Should bring you Michael Vick's day in court, plus learn why there are such great expectations for the Patriots this season, and hear Jose Canseco's words for Curt Schilling. All the details will be on Sports Desk with Hazel May tonight, immediately following our Red Sox coverage.
Six in a row retired by Kason Gabbard. Coming up just to the one hit tonight to Franklin Gutierrez, the home run in the third inning. Peralta lined up short first time up as he takes a pitch inside. And Gabbard falls behind 2-0. Gabbard on the road, no record coming in. He had two starts, two no decisions. Higher run average of 5.59. Away from Fenway Park, six earned runs in 9 2/3. The pitching line tonight for him is brought to you by Nissan. Struck out Sizemore in the third, struck out Hafner in the fourth inning. There's two K's tonight, and now a walk to Johnny Peralta. There's one away here in the fifth. First walk given up by Gabbard tonight.
He had that stretch earlier this season where he's having walk problems. Six walks against Seattle, four the next time out against Texas, but has been very good in that department recently. Certainly, you don't want to be walking guys when you have the eight-run lead.
Well, just two walks combined in the previous two outings and 16 innings pitched. Between his outing against Kansas City and then the next one against the White Sox. And with Jason Michaels, left fielder for the Indians, who popped out to shortstop first time up. Back up the middle and into center field just over the glove of Kason Gabbard. And it's first and second now with one away.
Michaels gets the fastball from Gabbard. It's right out over the plate and right back up the middle for the base hit. For the first time tonight, they have had back-to-back base runners. The walk, now the single.
Two on, one away. And it brings up Franklin Gutierrez. It's been a pain for the Red Sox this series. Hit a home run yesterday. And a home run today. Seven home runs on the season. Take strike one from Gabbard. Gutierrez appeared to the Cleveland Indians in 43 games last year. First major league experience for him was in 05, and he got in 7 games. By the Indians from the Dodgers in exchange for Milton Bradley back in 2004. Throws it the 0-1 and chops it foul outside of third base.
It was a fastball Gutierrez hit for the home run back in the third inning so far in this at bat, back-to-back curveballs.
Now look at the numbers for him in the month of July. 341, three homers. We've seen two of them. And seven runs batted in. Walt at second base. Michaels at first. One down. Gutierrez with a foul tip staying alive.
I don't think so. I don't think he made contact on that.
He ends up striking out. Beg your pardon. And there's out number two, third K for Gabbard.
And again, another curveball. Three straight curveballs and added back to Gutierrez in the very quick strikeout.
Three K's now for Gabbard. Popped out to second base, first time up. Fly ball out to left field. Manny Ramirez headed back onto the track at the wall, and it's off the wall. In from second is Peralta. He scores. Mike is behind him. Two runs in for the Indians. And it's now 9-3.
Now, Barfield saved a couple of runs defensively earlier in this game. Now he drives in two runs. Gets the fastball from Gabbard and puts it up on that left field wall. Picks up RBI number 45 and 46 on the season.
Two down, Barfield in scoring position at second base. It's the bottom of the order that's given Gabbard problems. All three hits coming from the 7-8-9 men for the Indians. And it's Sizemore who sends one into center field for a base hit. Barfield being waved around, he'll score. And the Indians climbing back into this one. It's down 9-4, Boston.
Now, Gabbard was kind of rolling along in this game, had that long wait while the Red Sox were scoring their five runs and has had problems in this inning. Sizemore on a curveball for the base hit to drive in a run.
And John Farrell to the mound for the first time tonight.
Well, be sure to be with us Sunday at 12 o'clock for the top nine countdown of all things Sox. Don't miss Granite City Electric Ultimate Red Sox Show. This week, Hazel May looks back at John Lester's return to the majors. And we go nine innings with Jonathan Papelbon. It's Sunday at noon, right before our pregame coverage begins.
Well, a great start for Gabbard, but he runs into trouble here in the fifth inning as they've scored three times on him. Now a quick check and a low throw. First base dug out by Euclid. You see Blake, the batter's 0 for 2 tonight. He's grounded out to third base, grounded out to second. Got a 9-1 lead coming into the inning. The Indians have cut it now to 9-4. Up and away to Casey Blake.
One thing Gabbard's done this inning, he's got away from his changeup a little bit. A curveball for a base hit for Sizemore, a fastball of Barfield for a hit, and Michaels hit on a fastball.
Falling behind 2-0, and all sudden action in the Red Sox pen as Julian Tavares has hopped up and he'll start to warm up. Side and Gabbard right now trying to find his control again. He's behind 3-0.
Well, he had a lot of pitches down the middle of the plate. Now it looks like he's trying to be too fine to pick up those corners, and the result, the 3-0 count.
They take it all the way and taking strike one over the inside corner. Second walk allowed of the inning. Wake to first, Sizemore to second. And it's two on with two down. You got Victor Martinez coming up. Well, Martinez is grounded out to third base on two occasions tonight. He's 0 for 2. For the Indians in the bottom of the fifth inning. Ball one to Martinez.
Deserting him, his fastball, his curveball, having trouble throwing strikes with everything.
Sizemore at second base, Blake at first base. Two down here in the bottom of the fifth. Been a three-run inning so far for the Indians. There's a strike, 3-1. Jeff Travis Hafner. Ball four, back-to-back walks allowed by Gabbard. Loads the bases now.
You got a real decision here. I mean, Gabbard scuffling. You got Travis half the lefty against lefty. Do you stay with him? One more guy.
Hafner hit 6 grand slams last season. Has 9 career grand slams. Tied Don Mattingly for a major league record of grand slams in one season. And here he is with the bases loaded and 2 down. One swing away from making it a 1-run game. The inning began. The Red Sox had a 9-1 advantage. And he hits Hafner with the first pitch. From third comes Sizemore. And it's now 9-5, Boston. comes Terry Francona. Only 23-minute wait for Gabbard between the fourth and fifth innings. He got the first batter of the inning, Ryan Garko. And things certainly went south after that. So far charged with the five runs in the inning. Still responsible for the men on. The Indians have the bases loaded as the Red Sox will go to the bullpen here with two down in the fifth. It's now 9-5 Boston. Tavares will be on. Runners at first and second, the third arm of the night used by Eric Wedge and the Cleveland Indians. Red Sox on top 9-5. It's Tom Nasty who comes on for Jason Stanford, who leaves after 2 1/3. Nasty into the game with one out and two on. 38 games for Nasty. 6-2 with a 4.43 ERA in the season, 40 2/3 innings, and a total of 40 strikeouts. Almost a strikeout an inning, actually a strikeout an inning for Masney.
And the second time that he has worked in this series, pitched against the Red Sox on the 23rd, pitched an inning in that game.
That's first and second with Veritek at second base, Crisp at first base, and one down. Pena batting from the number 9 spot. The Red Sox order tonight with two hits. Single and a double. He's knocked in a run. Oh, no. Lines this to deep left field. Mike goes back and that ball is gone. Line drive, 3-run home run for William O'Pena. Puts the Red Sox on top 12-5. Third hit of the night for Willie Moe, hits his fifth home run of the season.
Well, every time Terry Francona puts Payne in the lineup, he always says, we hope he runs into one. Well, he ran into one right there. I mean, that's a line shot that didn't take long at all to get out of this ballpark. So three hits tonight for Willie Moe Payne and 4 runs batted in.
No, 62 at bats in between home runs. In between Willie Moe Pena running into one.
Pena gets a fastball middle in and absolutely crushes this. And a nice catch, but I got to take a few points away because he's got a glove. Now you make that catch barehanded, you're talking about the play of the week.
In a hurt hand, that was a line shot. For Pena, his first home run since June 4th at Oakland. Hit one off Dan Heron. That's in there for a strike in the count, 2-1. And it's been a tough go, but for Willie Moe, lead on a daily basis that the Red Sox need another outfielder, perhaps, as you draw closer to the trade deadline. And Willie Moe Pena responding here tonight. And second three-hit game of the season. As Lugo drives it out towards center field, Grady Sizemore is back there to make the catch for the second out of the inning.
Well, see, those are the things that you see in Pena, you know, and if you saw it more consistently, you get something special there. I mean, this guy's got so much power, it's unbelievable. Problem is making contact, and if you notice tonight, I believe all his hits on fastballs in this game, which is a little bit surprising. You would think that the Indians, knowing that, would be throwing him more breaking pitches. But you're a scout, you're sitting down, you're watching something like that, you go, man, this guy's got unlimited power.
Well, Pedroia's 1-for-4 tonight. He singled in the fifth inning. Can you teach plate discipline? Is that something you can work on over the years?
It's hard. You know, as you get older, I think you can improve. But, you know, there are certain guys that are just aggressive hitters and not patient hitters. And Pena, when he falls behind and counts, they throw him a lot of pitches that are not strikes, and he'll chase them. And, I mean, yeah, you can talk, you can work on it, but it's still, you know, sometimes it's just you. It's the way you go about things.
It's strike to Pedroia, and the count evens now at 2-2.
I'll say this, that every time he's with a club, whether it be the Red Sox or whoever he's been with before, that everybody thinks that they can do that to him, you know, help him make those adjustments and become that type of a hitter. It's not that easy.
And the problem with this club is he's not going to get that much of an opportunity to play on a regular basis. Long time, sometimes in between at bats, which I'm sure does not help the situation either. After the breaking ball, fouls it off. Still 2-2.
I mean, he's in a dog race right now for top dog in his game with Ramirez, Lowell, and Pena. I mean, it's close right now. And he knows it. That's quite an honor here. Manny knows it. He knows he's going to do something big now because Pena. Mike knows it. Mike goes to the website. He told me. He loves it.
Which website is that?
The one I mentioned once in a while, the RimReport.com.
Swing and a miss by Pedroia. And he strikes out to end the inning. The damage done. Three-run shot for Willie Mulpena. Last half of the seventh inning back at Jacobs Field in Cleveland. The Red Sox get three runs in the top half of the inning on the three-run shot for Willie Mulpena. It's 12-5 Boston. And Julian Tavares back out there. He came on in the fifth. And has retired all four batters. His face since coming in at a 1-2-3 sixth inning. Josh Barfield leading it off here for the Indians. And chopping it foul. Grounds it at the shortstop, Lugo. And on the throw off the mark, Varitek will back it up, but Barfield will reach. Tough throw from Lugo. And will be charged with an error.
That's one of the few times this season where Lugo has made a bad throw to first base. You know, that was a problem in the past, but he's got a lot of that straightened out this year. This ball just sails on him, and he knew it as soon as he let it go.
Barfield aboard at first base. First miscue of the night for the Red Sox. The Sox have committed just five errors in the last 21 games. And nine now in the last 38 contests. Good percentage has been improving. This one's some foul off to the left, back and out of play. Moved up to third highest in the American League at 986 fielding percentage for Boston.
Now they've come a long way defensively. They were way down 11-12 for a long time and have climbed that ladder quickly.
Red Sox are third. They're behind Baltimore, who leads the American League. 47 errors made by the Orioles this season. And then Minnesota is second. Red Sox third heading into tonight's action. The 0-1 misses. 1-1 to Grady Sizemore. 1-for-3 in the game tonight. Strike two. 1-2 to Sizemore. Singled and knocked in a run in the fifth inning. Four-run bottom of the fifth that spelled the end of the night for Kason Gabbard. He's not eligible to get a victory here tonight, but not go the minimum necessary to make himself eligible. As he went 4 2/3 before departing. Sizemore with a swing and a miss. He strikes out. It's the third strikeout for Tavares. And the first out here in the bottom of the seventh inning.
And he has strikeouts on all of his pitches, his fastball, his slider. That's the changeup right there for the strikeout to Sizemore. Sizemore, with two strikeouts now tonight, has 102 on the season.
So one down, Barfield at first base, and Casey Blake's the batter. He's 0 for 2 with a walk in the game.
That 102 strikeouts leads the American League. Brandon Inge is second. Curtis Granderson third.
We were talking a little earlier about Tavares having success first time through the lineup. Here are the numbers. Opposition hitting at 205 first time through, and then as a starter second time would get higher, and third time through 394 for Julian Tavares.
Stunning.
No one to Blake is in there for a strike, and it's 0-2. One out, one on. Short lead at first base for Barfield. As Lugo ducks back a step or two. And there's two away here in the bottom of the seventh inning.
Now is the time to sign up for the annual Red Sox Fantasy Camp in Fort Myers just before spring training begins. Play for a week with the heroes you grew up admiring, from Yaz to Rice to Evans to Tion to Jupiter. To join this extraordinary week of fun in the sun, call 617-226-6400.
Imagine Adam Jupiter in the uniform. Two down here in the last half of the seventh inning. Victor Martinez, the batter.
Hey, you had Adam, you know, as your coach today, you know, guys, Tion, Rice, Evan, all those guys. Who you got? I got Jupiter. Who's Jupiter?
Who are you again? I played for the Mets. Victor Martinez, 0 for 2 with a walk tonight. Offfield reach to begin the inning on an error committed by Julio Lugo at throwing in. He still stands at first with two down. In the dirt, Veritek secures it. Moving to his right. And so far, Tavares has allowed just one base runner, and again, it's on the air by Lugo. Otherwise, he's retired. Everybody else that he's faced. Over three strikeouts. The 2-1 pitch. Inside 3-1. I would imagine that we are almost to August and the Red Sox will be making just their first visit of the year to Tropicana Field.
And we'll see plenty of Tropicana Field in the remainder of July, August, and September. That's for sure. Three trips.
Four to Martinez. And then the first walk given up by Julian Tavares.
Right after the game from the Nesson HD Television Center, it's WB Mason Extra Innings with John Barron and Dave McCarty. You'll get Kason Gabbard's postgame comments, plus highlights from Curt Schilling's rehab start in Toledo for the Paw Sox and from around the majors, including the Yankees and Royals in Kansas City. It's all right after the game in high definition on Nesson.
Runners at first and second, two down here for the Indians, and it brings up Travis Hafner. DH has grounded out to first base, struck out looking, and been hit by a pitch tonight. Hafner fouls the first one off. Shift on for Hafner. Ball stays closer towards the bag. And there's a pitch in there for strike, and it's 0-2. Hafner disagrees. Pitch to Hafner. He is outside 1-2. A 1-2 pitch to Travis Hafner. Backs off. After lines it into left field, a base hit. Barfield being waved around, he will score. And it's now 12-6. So the error that began the inning turns into a run as Barfield comes around to score. And Hafner picks up his 65th RBI of the season.
That breaks a long hitless streak for Hafner, 0 for his last 21 before getting hit by a pitch last time up. And now going to the opposite field for the base hit to drive in a run.
Here Lopez with some stirring down in the Red Sox bullpen. They're about to start warming up here as all of a sudden Tavares running into some trouble in the seventh. And Garco the batter with two down. Runners at first and second. And Garco hits a fly ball to deep right field. Panda goes back at the wall. He leaps and it's gone. A three-run home run for Ryan Garco. And it's now 12-9 Boston. Second look Garco had at Tavares. He was the first batter that he faced.
And showing some opposite field power here, too. Number 13 on the season for Garco. So once again, here come the Indians. Payne going back. He'll run out of room as that ball lands in the first row.
Well, there's been no give up in the Indians tonight as they have come back again.
Twice tonight it looked like this was going to be an easy win for the Red Sox, but yet the Indians have made it interesting again.
Well, after back-to-back 1-0 games, so far 21 runs between the two clubs tonight. As this one is carved foul off to the right.
Now this. This is more like you expect in the American League. A game like tonight, the last couple have been very rare.
Johnny Peralta is 0 for 2 with a walk tonight. Came around to score a run in the fifth. And the air is big to begin the inning for Lugo. And as this pitch is in the dirt, that would have been out number one. And of course, the strikeout and the pop out. Here's Jensen Lewis, who had been up earlier, and back up again now for Eric Webb. A 2-1 pitch. Peralta chops it softly. Tavares off the mound, spins, and throws a one-hopper to first as Euclid's cut the toe on the bag. Tavares ends up giving up 4 runs in the inning. It is 12-9 Red Sox at the end of seven. Well, leadoff walk for David Ortiz here in the top half of the eighth. It's 12-9. Red Sox on top, and the new pitcher is Jensen Lewis.
Well, it's been the fast track this year. Double-A to start, Triple-A for a while, and back up to the big leagues, making his fifth appearance, his second in this series. Only 5 1/3 innings, 5 hits, 8 strikeouts for Jensen Lewis. He is a native of Cincinnati, Ohio.
Lenny Ramirez bats with David Ortiz at first base. Nobody out here in the eighth inning. Lenny hit a home run back in the second inning. A solo shot. He walked in the fourth, doubled in the fifth, and grounded into a fielder's choice in the sixth inning. And again, swinging at that first pitch. Misses it this time.
You saw Lewis the other night. He's got a very good fastball, 95. With that last fastball.
Ball and a strike down to Manny Ramirez.
Like the backswing got Victor Martinez. Lewis again throwing the fastball by Manny, and it gets him right off the left shoulder, it looks like.
Green will do it again with a count of 1-2. Tom Nasty went 2/3 of an inning. He gave up the 3-run home run to Willie Mopena, charged with one of those runs. And still responsible for David Ortiz, who he walked to begin things here in the eighth inning. Jensen Lewis, the fourth pitcher of the night for the Indians. Starters tonight leaving in the fifth inning. Cliff Lee, 4+ innings, giving up 8 runs. Kason Gabbard, 4 2/3, giving up 5 runs. And for Gabbard, it kind of came apart pretty quickly in the fifth. Outside, 2-2. Gabbard had started the night by retiring 13 of the first 14 batters that he faced. Given up a couple of hits, walked 3, hit a batter, all in the fifth inning. A 4-run bottom of the fifth inning for the Indians, and a chase Gabbard from the game. 2-2 misses, and it's a full count now to Manning.
Just missing the outside corner for Lewis. And you can see Victor Martinez try to pull it back on the corner.
Pitch to Ramirez. Fly ball to deep center field. Back goes Grady Sizemore. At the wall, he leaps. It's gone. Manny's gone deep twice tonight. 2-run home run this time, and his 17th home run of the year. Red Sox take a 14-9 lead.
Well, twice to center field tonight for Manny Ramirez. This one not quite as deep as the first one, but certainly deep enough. Sizemore goes back. It looked like for a second he might have a chance at it, but no. Up over the wall, so Ramirez with a big night. Thank you.
Three hits in the game for Ramirez, four RBIs, two homers. And the second multi-home run game of the season, the 49th of his career. And the Red Sox on top again by five now as Euclid swings and foul tips it. Left side of the backhand goes Peralta. Long throw that'll get there in time for the first out of the inning.
Well, a lot of Red Sox players having big nights tonight. Certainly Manny Ramirez with the biggest. Mike Lowell, Veritek with a couple of runs batted in. Pena with four RBI. You know, Manny might be getting into one of those streaks. You know, you look at the numbers, and you know, has he gonna reach 30 home runs, 17 now total on the season? Certainly has time to surpass that. Big thing is the RBIs now is starting to pile up for Manny. With four tonight, gives him 64.
He's had 19 RBIs in the last 15 games.
Oh, I got a good one for you. I'm in the clubhouse this afternoon writing down the lineups, and Manny out of the clear blue sky says, hey, when I'm done playing, can I be on Nesson? I says, what is it going to be, a reality show?
Yeah, I was going to say, what does he want to do?
I mean, you never know what is going to come out of his mouth.
Picks it. Throws out his counterpart at third base. Two down in the inning.
Now think about it. What role could Manny possibly play with Nesson? Pre and post game analyst. He may not show up.
There's that possibility.
Yeah, who knows? I can't see him interviewing anybody because he doesn't like to be interviewed himself.
Well, maybe if he was on the other side, it might be a little easier for him.
He could say Buenas noches, amigos, every night.
Yeah, but then he'd take that away from you. That's such an important part of your broadcast.
I do have that trademark, yeah. But, you know, I mean, you never know from day to day what, you know. I mean, most of the time I get, you know, like I got no pop.
Yep.
Something like that. But today, I want to work at Nesson. Okay? Well, I'll see what I can do, Manny. I'm sure you need the money. There's no question about that, you know.
Nesson has plenty of other shows. He could be on 10.0. Bob Ryan.
You can just see how that would go, too. You know, Bob would make some point, and he'd be going off like he goes off, and then he'd go, you crazy, man.
Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Relax.
Got no pop, man.
Swing and a miss for Veritek. He strikes out. Well, a two-run shot for Manny Ramirez, a future employee of Nesson. 14-9 Red Sox. Oh, he head to the bottom of the ninth inning. 14-9 Red Sox on top. As Javier Lopez is into the game.
Second appearance of the series for Lopez. Pitched a third of an inning on the 23rd. Overall, his 40th appearance of the season.
First base is Grady Sizemore to begin things here in the bottom of the ninth. And Sizemore takes strike one. He is 1-for-4 in the game tonight with an RBI. As he singled as part of a four-run fifth inning. The Indians have had two innings tonight in which they have scored four times. But still trail 14-9 as they bat here in the bottom of the ninth. has more, chops it to first. Euculus on the backhand. Lopez will cover for the first out of the ninth inning. So one down. Brings up Casey Blake, who's 0 for 3 tonight with a walk. Sox pitching allowing 4 walks in the game tonight. 3 of them charged to Gabbard as part of his tough inning and the end of his night.
And a lot of this big crowd has left.
34,268 to begin the night. That's a pretty good crowd. It's a jerked feel for this 4-game series. Only trip of the year for the Red Sox to Cleveland during the regular season anyway. That's now Victor Martinez waiting on deck as the Indians bat the bottom of the ninth. Outside 2-1.
Well, the Red Sox can come out of this game with the win and take 3 out of 4 here in Cleveland against this club. That's a pretty darn good start to this road trip.
And it inside, and it's now 3-1. It's a fly ball to right field, sending Pena back. He's got plenty of room to secure out number 2. 2 down in the ninth. So 2 away, and Victor Martinez coming up. He has walked twice tonight and has grounded out to third base twice. Red Sox and Tampa Bay Devil Rays begin a 3-game series tomorrow night. Tim Wakefield matched up against Jason Hamill. Wakefield will be looking for his 12th win of the year. He is 11-9. Martinez fouls it off to the right. It's nothing in one. Well, the Red Sox can hold on. That means they will have taken 5 out of 7 from the Indians this season. Of course, the Red Sox won 2 out of 3 at Fenway Park in the only series at Fenway. With Schilling and Beckett getting the victories in the first 2 games. Paul Byrd getting the win in the 3rd game of that series. He beat Daisuke. The 0-1. Outside, a ball and a strike to Martinez. Red Sox have better their record at 28-21 on the road. Heading in tonight with a 27-21 record, the second best road winning percentage in the major leagues. Only behind the Detroit Tigers, who are 34-19 on the road. Left side of the backhand goes Lugo. A long throw that will get there in plenty of time. Nice play. The Red Sox do indeed win. A 14-9 victory for Boston as they take 3 out of 4 from the Cleveland Indians. And they bang out 17 hits. A big night for Manny Ramirez. A couple of home runs tonight for Manny. A 4 RBI performance and a 14-9 Red Sox win.